start something like a mini series of my top 10, top 20, top 30 things. So I'll start this series with my top 30 movies. I planned it to be my top 10 movies, but when I looked through my movie library, I found that there's many more movies worth mentioning. Maybe some movies, depending on your age, that you don't even know yet. So, let's start. Position 30 on my list is a film from 1995. It's called Hackers. Johnny Lee Miller and Angelina Jolie are main actors in this movie, and they are both still in their teens. It's a very entertaining look at the early days of the internet, and especially at the young Angelina Jolie. When I still was in my teens, this film came out, and wow, she was a really hot babe. Absolutely. And she still is. Position 29 on my list is a film from 2003. It's Underworld, with Kate Beckinsale, Scott Speedman, and Michael Sheen. You like stylish vampires? I do. So, that's good enough reason to be on my list. Position 28. A film from 2002. It's called Equilibrium, starring Christian Bale, Emily Watson, and Taye Diggs. It's a, well, dystopian science fiction. And if you don't know it, you should give it a watch. It's a lot about gun kata, which is a mix of martial arts and gunfighting, and that's totally cool. I really like that in this film, so give it a try. It's quite entertaining. Position 27 on my list is Jumper. Very good as good if you watch a translation, or if you have to watch it with subtitles, because a lot of the dialogues are extremely witty, smart, and funny. So I think with translation, a lot could be lost. Number 25 on my list is a film from 1998. It's Blade, with Wesley Snipes, Stephen Dorff, and Kris Kristofferson. It's lots of action, great visual style, and more action, and more action, and more action. I just love Wesley Snipes' action films. It's just cool and entertaining to watch. Number 24 on my list is a film from 2009, Knowing, with Nicolas Cage and Rose Byrne. This film is not liked by everyone, but I like the story, and I have watched this film numerous times. The next film on my list, number 23, is from 2009. The film title is Push, with Chris Evans and Dakota Fanning. This film got several bad critiques, but I like it nevertheless. Superhero films with an interesting plot and some very uncommon superpowers are hard to find, and I think this is a pretty good one, actually. Number 22 on my list, a film from 1997, The Fifth Element, with Bruce Willis, Gary Oldman, Ian Holm, Chris Tucker, and Mila Jovovich. It's a fun story, many, many laughs. And if you can say so, it's science fiction going pop art. It's a film that doesn't take itself so seriously and makes a lot of fun of the genre, but still isn't a stupid film. I don't know how to say that in English. It's not a film making fun of another film. This film is just finding the funny parts in a whole genre, but not copying it, so you will not find a funny version of Darth Vader in this film. Not at all. So if you don't know The Fifth Element, you definitely need to watch it. Number 21 on my list is a film from 2003. And this was a very good year for films. You will find a few more from that year in my list. And the film is called Lost in Translation, with Bill Murray and Scarlett Johansson. As some of you might know, I have been living in South Korea for 5 years. So when I'm watching this movie, I remember how I felt when I moved to Korea. I think not the typical Hollywood special effects movie. Guns blazing, lots of action. No, not at all. It's just science and a little bit of magic. And I really love that film. I don't know, I've probably watched it 20 times or more so far. Number 19, The Lake House from 2006 with Sandra Bullock and Keanu Reeves. I think this is one of the smartest stories, one of the smartest concepts of a time travel story. I've never seen anything similar to that. It's pretty cool. I really like that film. And it's romantic, and I'm all for romantic films, as you will see later on my list. Number 18 is a film from 2010 with Denzel Washington, Gary Oldman, and Mila Kunis. It's called The Book of Eli. It's a great post-apocalyptic film that has such an unexpected end that makes so much sense when it's revealed, but it was so incredibly unexpected that for this alone, it's worth to watch this film. Number 17 on my list is There for Very Unusual Reasons. It's a film from 2010 with Angelina Jolie and Liev Schreiber. It's Salt. And the reason why this film is on my list is because this was the most dangerous film of 2010. I used to work for a big insurance company, and this company insured more than 80% of all Hollywood blockbusters. And in 2010, this film had the riskiest stunts in it because Angelina Jolie was doing all of the stunts on her own. All of the stunts, even jumping from a bridge onto a driving truck. She did everything on her own. Just watch this film knowing that she did all that. This is incredible. Number 16 on my list is Full Metal Jacket from 1987 with Matthew Modine and Vincent D'Onofrio. It's a Stanley Kubrick film. It's a very intense story. Not always easy to watch, but in my opinion, one of the best Vietnam War films ever made. Number 15 on my list is a German film. Again, it's from 2010. The German title is Wir sind die Nacht. The English translation and the English title is We Are the Night, with Caroline Herfurth, Nina Hoss, and Jennifer Ulrich. It's one of the few German films I actually like. And best of all, it is a great vampire story. Not at all like those teeny vampire films like Twilight. So, if you haven't seen it, you definitely fighting scenes in this movie. Those alone are worth watching it. Number 13. With Nicolas Cage, Angelina Jolie again. Vinnie Jones as the Sphinx. A film from the year 2000. Gone in 60 seconds. In this film you have great cars. A fun story. You have Angelina Jolie with blonde dreadlocks. And the best part of the film is Vinnie Jones as the Sphinx. This is just priceless. I could re-watch the scene where he was introduced just over and over again. He's such a fun guy. Again, on position 12, a Vietnam film from 1987. Good Morning, Vietnam, with Robin Williams and Forrest Whitaker. It's combining manic comedy and melancholic drama, and it adds Robin Williams, and all that makes a great film that you can watch over and over again, and you never get tired of watching. Now we're coming to another romantic drama from 1999. One of my all-time favorite romantic films. Notting Hill with Julia Roberts and Hugh Grant. Horse and Hound. Is there anything else I need to say? Wow. We are already at position 10. So now we are in the top 10. Number 10 is a film from 2008. Starring Clint Eastwood. Directed by Clint Eastwood. The film is called Gran Torino. It's a sometimes very humorous and always very touching film. In my opinion, one of the best works by Clint Eastwood. On position 9, we actually have three movies that for me count as one. It's the original Star Wars movies starring Mark Hamill, Harrison Ford, and Carrie Fisher, mostly directed by George Lucas. It's just an epic work. For those of the younger ones, now you would call it episodes 4, 5, and 6. That's the original episodes. Top 8, a film from 2011, starring Justin Timberlake and Amanda Seyfried, In Time. I love the originality of the story, and actually, the first time when I really liked Justin Timberlake as an actor. Top 7, 1986, Platoon, with Tom Berenger, Willem Dafoe, and Charlie Sheen. This is probably the best film ever made about the Vietnam War. The film does not give you the regular Hollywood action hero, but gives you a ground level view of the horrific war in Vietnam. If you haven't watched it, well, you need to be, I think, 16, but watch it. It's incredible. Horrifying, but incredible. Top 6 on my list might be a film that not everyone agrees upon. It's The Beach from 2000, starring Leonardo DiCaprio and Tilda Swinton. Even though the film got very bad critiques, I love the gorgeous cinematography. It sure was not DiCaprio's best work, but I can watch this movie again and again. We're approaching the top 5. Position 5 in my favorite movies list is again a film with Scarlett Johansson, Morgan Freeman, and Jimin Chik. It's a film from 2014, directed by Luc Besson. The film is called Lucy. It's a fantastic story. It's the ultimate intelligence fighting the ultimate villain. If you don't know the film, you have to watch it. It is absolutely great and entertaining. Position 4 on my list is a Quentin Tarantino film. Actors are Uma Thurman, David Carradine, Lucy Liu, and Daryl Hannah. It's a film from 2003. I mentioned that this is a good year, or this was a good year, for movies. It's Kill Bill Volume 1. I must admit that I do not like Volume 2 as much, but Volume 1 just is a classic. I love all of Tarantino's films, probably with the exception of Volume 2. They would all have deserved a spot in this list, but representative for his work, I think I picked Kill Bill Volume 1. Which is absolutely Tarantino's best film ever, even better than Pulp Fiction. My opinion. Top 3 in my list is another romantic comedy. Oh, it is a film that I watch at least twice or three times a year. It's a film that I definitely watch every Christmas. It was directed by Richard Curtis. By the way, I usually cry when I see this film. Some actors in this film are Hugh Grant, Keira Knightley, Colin Firth, Liam Neeson, not killing anyone, Emma Thompson, Alan Rickman, and many, 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 many more. And the film is Love Actually. This is a story where I really cry every time when I watch it. I just love it. just falling in love with all those tragic characters. Number two on my list is a film from 1999. It's directed by the Wachowski brothers. Wachowski brothers? Wachowski, I think you say in American. Actors are Keanu Reeves, Lawrence Fishburne, and Carrie Ann Moss. So you know what it is. It's The Matrix. I think this film invented a lot of visual effects, and for 1999, it was absolutely spectacular when they introduced this effect known now as bullet time, where a camera or where a set of cameras move around the actor and you see like a slow motion, and at the same time the camera is moving around the character in normal speed, which is just incredible. I love the story of the film. And most of all, I love Carrie Ann Moss as Trinity in this film. Absolutely stunning. So now, we are at my personal number one film. Probably watched by me, I don't know, 30 times. Directed by Edward Zwick. Actors are Tom Cruise and Ken Watanabe. It's a film from 2003, and it's called The Last Samurai. I think this film gives us an insight into the Japanese mindset. It shows wonderful pictures and has much slower pace than most of the Hollywood action movies. I really, really love this film, even though Tom Cruise is not one of my favorite actors, but in this film, I think he really did well. So, The Last Samurai is my personal all-time favorite movie. Tell me in the comments what your favorite movies are. Maybe there's something I need to watch. I hope you like this whispering and tapping top 13.